Heavy fluids can significantly reduce the natural frequencies of a structure. Hello, I'm Armin. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll show you how to calculate the natural frequency of a beam submerged in water using Ansys. Let me explain this briefly. When a structure is in contact with a heavy fluid, its natural frequencies decrease. This effect is especially noticeable in submerged structures or fluid storage tanks, where the added mass of the fluid shifts the natural frequencies to lower values. In this tutorial, we'll investigate the behavior of a submerged cantilever beam in water. The theoretical natural frequencies will be calculated using an analytical expression. Since the surrounding water adds extra mass, the natural frequencies are reduced. I'll begin by creating the geometry in SpaceClaim, which includes both the beam and the fluid domain. The beam is made of structural steel and is modeled as a cantilever. The tank is filled with water and open at the top. We use Modal Acoustics because calculating the natural frequency directly from the Navier Stokes equations is not straightforward. We've defined two regions, one structural and one acoustic, corresponding to the beam and the fluid, respectively. Now, let's start the modeling process. The first step is to add a modal acoustic system because I want to calculate the natural frequencies of a structure submerged in fluid. Let's begin by creating the geometry. Right-click on Geometry and select New SpaceClaim Geometry. In this section, we'll prepare the geometry by starting with the fluid domain. Go to the Sketch tab, choose the Rectangle tool, and click on the coordinate origin. The dimensions are 0.5 by 1 meter, so enter 500 millimeters for the width and 1,000 millimeters for the height, then press Enter. Finally, click End Sketch Editing. Now, we need to extrude this sketch to create a 3D block. Click on the sketch, type 500, and press Enter. As you can see, the geometry has been created. Press the Escape key twice to exit the extrude tool. The fluid domain is now ready. Let's rename it from solid to fluid. Go to the structure tree, right-click on solid which represents the fluid domain, choose Rename, and type Fluid. In the second step, I need to create a beam inside the fluid domain. To start sketching, we need a surface reference. Select the left surface of the fluid block, then go to the Sketch tab and click on Sketch Mode. Click on Plan View to switch to the normal viewing angle. I want to draw a square in this area, so I'll choose the Rectangle tool and draw a square. The dimensions are 80 millimeters by 80 millimeters. Enter the values and press Enter. So far, everything looks good. Now, let's define the size and position of the square. Select the Dimension tool, then click on one side of the square. The dimension is correct since we just entered it. Let's do the same for the other side. As you can see, the square becomes overconstrained because all four sides are equal. We need to delete one of the dimensions to fix the constraint issue. The square is off-center in the fluid domain. We can correct its location using symmetry constraint or additional dimensions. I will go with the second option. Select Dimension in the Sketch tab and add a dimension between one side of the square and the y-axis of the origin. Type 40 millimeters and press Enter. Repeat the same for the x-axis and enter 40 millimeters. Now, the square is perfectly centered within the fluid domain. Next, hide the fluid body so we don't merge it with the solid part. Then, click on End Sketch Editing. A square surface has now been created. Choose the square surface and extrude it. Type 50 millimeters and press Enter. This solid block will act as the support for the beam, which will be attached to it. I'll click on the top surface of the support and select Sketch Mode. Then, click on Plan View to switch to a normal top-down view. Go to the Sketch tab and select the Rectangle tool. Click on one side of the square and hover to the opposite side, then click to draw the rectangle. The height of the beam is 20 millimeters, so I'll use the Dimension tool to set the height. Click on the vertical side of the rectangle, enter 20 millimeters, and press Enter. To center the beam, select the upper square side and origin line, then enter 10 millimeters as the dimension. Everything looks good so far. Click on End Sketch Editing. Now, extrude the rectangle by selecting it, typing 500 millimeters, and pressing Enter. The beam has been created. Press Escape twice to exit the Extrude tool. Let's check the solid name. The solid name is correct, so no changes are needed. At this point, we have two domains. Solid is the beam, and fluid is the water domain. We need to subtract the fluid domain from the solid domain. Go to the Design tab and select the Combine tool. First, select the fluid part. A saw icon will appear. Then, select the solid part. You'll see three parts in the structure tree. Click on the new part and delete it. Press Escape twice to exit the tool. Next, let's make the fluid domain transparent so we can see inside. Click on the fluid part, then change its appearance from opaque to transparent using this icon. Hide the solid part to better visualize the result. As you can see, the solid has been subtracted from the fluid block. These two parts are now separate, so we need to couple them using Shared Topology. Go to the Workbench tab and select the Shared Topology tool. Click the green check mark to apply it. The geometry is now prepared. We don't need to add anything else, so we can close the geometry. In this step, I want to prepare the model setup. So, I'm going to double-click on the model cell. Inside the model environment, we can define boundary conditions and assign materials to each part. This is the outline tree where we can see geometry, mesh, and modal acoustics. In the first step, I want to specify materials for each part. I'll expand the geometry branch, where we can see the two domains, fluid and solid, that we created earlier in SpaceClaim. I'll click on the fluid domain, and in the material section, I'll change the material from structural steel to water liquid, since this is the fluid part. The solid part is already assigned to structural steel by default, so no changes are needed there. If we want to use a different material, we can simply type its name into the filter and select it from a list. Next, let's move on to generating the mesh. First, I'll generate the default mesh. The initial element size is too coarse, so we need to refine it. In the Details window, expand the Sizing section and increase the resolution. For example, set to 4. Note that the maximum resolution value is 7. Update the mesh and check the result. The element size now looks suitable for our simulation. Now, we need to define the structural and acoustic regions, which correspond to the solid and fluid parts, respectively. By default, only the acoustics region is defined. I'll click on the acoustic region, and we can see that all parts are currently defined as acoustics. Let's add a structural region. Right-click on Modal Acoustics, go to the Insert menu, and choose Physics Region. I need to select the beam because it represents the structural part. Choose the body selector. Then, select the beam and click Apply. In the definition section, set structure to yes. Now, the beam is defined as the structural region. Next, we need to exclude the beam from the acoustic region. I'll click on the acoustic region, then select the block domain, which represents the fluid, and click apply. As you can see, the two regions have now been correctly assigned. Finally, I'll press the H key to return to the default view. Let's define the boundary conditions for both the fluid and structural domains. First, I'll apply a boundary condition to the beam. This section of the beam is fixed in our model. I'll right-click on Modal Acoustics, and from the Insert menu, you'll see two sections, Acoustics and Structural. Under Structural, I'll choose Fixed Support, then select the beam surface and click Apply. As you can see, the fixed boundary condition has been applied successfully. The top side of the rectangular tank is open, so it requires a zero pressure boundary condition to represent an open surface. I'll right-click on Modal Acoustics, go to the acoustic section of the Insert menu, and choose Pressure. Then, I'll select the top surface of the fluid block and click Apply. By default, the pressure magnitude is set to zero, which is what we need. Now let's solve the model. Right-click on Modal Acoustics and click Solve. An error occurs, and that's because the model doesn't have any damping defined. To fix this, I'll go to Analysis Settings, and under Solver Controls, I'll change damping from no to yes. Now we can solve the model again. Right-click on Modal Acoustics and choose Solve. This time, the solution completes without any errors. Click on Solution and you'll see the natural frequencies. To visualize the mode shapes, click on the edge, right-click, and choose Create Mode Shape Result. Now, simply click Evaluate All Results. Then, click on Total Deformation to view the mode shapes. However, we can't see the beam's mode shapes clearly because it's hidden behind the fluid domain. To fix this, I'll navigate to the geometry and select it, right-click on the fluid domain, and select Hide Body. Go back to Total Deformation, and now we can clearly see the beam's mode shape. This concludes the main part of the tutorial. But what happens if we use air instead of water? First, let's make the fluid part visible again. Navigate to Geometry, expand it, and select the fluid domain. In the Material section, change water, liquid to air. Then, solve the model again. The solution completes successfully. Click on Solution to view the natural frequencies. As you can see, the natural frequencies have increased, and that's because air has less mass than water. Once again, hide the fluid domain to view the beam mode shapes more clearly. And that wraps up this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel for more Ansys and Console tutorials.